say on LGBTQ youth mental health. And for lack of a more eloquent or scientific term, the data were really, really, really rough. In particular, the study found that 39% of LGBTQ youth and more than half of transgender and non-binary youth report having seriously considered suicide in the past 12 months. On top of that, we know that schools are a place where a lot of this violence can occur for students. So as an educator, I always ask myself a couple of questions. The biggest one being, with the platform that I have, what can I do to make things better, right? And with particular regard to this issue, what can I do to help all of my students gain a sense of empathy for people who might be experiencing this every day, and hopefully motivate them towards some kind of pro-social action, right? Question number one. And then question number two, for my LGBTQ students in particular, how can I transform the idea of school from a place where things like this happen versus a place where they feel represented and seen and cared for, right? Here's how I do it with this assignment. So all the details are on the SPSSI website. I'll have a link for you at the very end, but I'll go through this very quickly. So modeled after the national effort by GLSEN, for those who are not familiar, they do a national day of silence in like every April to raise awareness for the bullying that queer youth face regularly. So for my students, I have them do a little day of silence writing assignment to hopefully instantiate some of that empathy. So real simple, I just ask them, for the day, refrain from speaking, and I also ask them to go a little bit further, to refrain from posting on social media, to make sure that they don't get anything that approximates a sense of belonging or social approval, right? And then do that for the entire day. I'm not going to read all of this for you because I keep this quick, but I basically tell them to reflect in any way that's meaningful for you, to have a couple of guiding questions to get them going, but most importantly, the one I care about the most is to have them think about whether people in their lives, past or present, may experience the kind of alienation they just had for 24 hours. Think about whether people experience that on a daily basis and reflect on their own perspective, right? Here's how students respond to this. Granted, I forgot to mention this, I don't have every single student do this. They have like 15 writing prompts that they can choose to complete. So there is a little bit of selection bias, but when students do this assignment, they find it very, very, very one student responded, "What I lost in normal conversations with my friends, I gained a perspective. I'm gratified that I was given the opportunity, and I would never hesitate to recommend this exercise to anyone." One of the high school students I taught a couple summers ago wrote that this activity changed my perspective because to a certain extent, I was left without a voice and had always taken my speech for granted. We must speak up for those around us and be more aware of these situations and take a closer look at how we treat those around us and then change our attitudes and our habits for that is why I teach, right? And I think I speak for a lot of people here. That is why I do what I do. So thank you all so much for listening. I hope that was 5 minutes. If you want a description, there it is. Enjoy. Thank you.